Paging Miss Krista Huyong. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. May I request everyone to please rise for the opening prayer to be led by Pastor Lovejoy Hesha Kimpo Leysa, and please remain standing for the singing of the Philippine National Anthem with the Excel Choral and Ms. Krista Huyong conducting.
Let us pray. Our Master Creator, God, whose breath makes us dance, whose embrace makes us sing, whose hands creatively molded us unique, we come to you today with grateful hearts for the talents and gifts you have given us. We are blessed with a rich culture as Filipinos, as Centralians, and we embrace it as we celebrate today. We acknowledge your presence here with us, and it's our desire that as we witness the presentations, we will be reminded of your great faithfulness to our dear Central and to all of us. Be with us, the participants and everyone present. Receive the highest recognition, honor, and praise in everything we say and do today. This is our humble prayer. In Jesus' name, amen.
Bayang mag-iliw, perlas ng silanganan, alam ng puso sa litig mo'y buhay. Lupang hinirang, duyan ka ng magiting, sa manlulupig, di ka pasisihil. Sa dagat at bundok, sa simoy at sa langit mong bugaw, may dilatang tula at awit sa paglayang minamahal. Ang kisap ng watawat mo'y tagumpay na nagdinigning, ang bituin at araw niyang kailan pa may di magdidilim. Lupa ng araw na wala at ipagsinta, buhay ay langit sa piling mo.
You may now all be seated. This is the second day of our Grand Alumni Homecoming 2020. And to welcome us all in this afternoon's event, may I call on our Vice President for Student Affairs, Dr. Esther Rose Romarate.
Maayong hapon gid sa inyo tanan. Good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of the Central Philippine University Administration, led by our President, Dr. Chidoro C. Robles, faculty, staff, and students, and on behalf of the CPU Alumni Association Incorporated, led by Attorney Joshua Alim, I warmly welcome all of you to this back-to-back event, which honors our Filipino culture and our Centralian heritage. I would like to especially give a warm welcome to our honorees, some of our retired faculty and staff who once served our beloved alma mater. I'm sure you would all agree with me that they have been a big part of our wealth of school day memories. This afternoon, we will be wowed by three cultural groups featuring our students, and they will entertain us through songs and dances and some theatrical acts. Now, these groups are First, we have the CPU Excel Choral, directed by Miss Krista Huyong. The second is Teatro Sining at Iba Pa, directed by Miss Grace Hardinil and Mrs. Ruella Cheyenne Aperia. And the third one is the CPU Dance Troupe, directed by Mr. Randy Lero. Also, we will be equally amazed by God's faithfulness to the lives of our retired faculty and staff members who continue to shine their light to us. We will honor these Centralian luminaries, for we believe that the Lord has used them to bless Central Philippine University, not only in the prime of their lives, but even now that they have advanced in years. So again, welcome and good afternoon. Thank you for choosing to be part of this momentous event.
Thank you very much, Dr. Esther Rose Rumarate. Alumni, friends, Centralians, let us give a round of applause to the cultural show entitled Pag-ulikid, Looking Back, Giving Back.
Thank you. Thank you. swimming.
Thank you.
Oh,
CSR1 to cashier 1, please. Thank you. CSR1 to cashier 1, please. Thank you.
Oh, miss, excuse me. Exit that way, please.
Oh, sorry, sir. I was thinking something up there.
Ah, okay lang, ma'am.
Thank you.
Nano man? Anong klaseng scanner? Pag-o pa lang gani, piki siguro ay. Pero, ano to ang tunog man? Do nabatian ko na ni mo? Ka-familiar? Ga-liwat-liwat sa ulo ko? Ah! Dumduman ko na gali sa CPU! Sang una, sang sa CPU pa ko ga-duty. Isa ato ka pinaka-memorable ng eksperyensya. Ano pa, hasta subong, madumduman, and mabatian ko pa ang bell niya sa ulo ko. Hindi lang eksperyensya ang nakuha ko to. Damo man ko to may nakilala kag nasugata. Kapin pa ang mga big bosses. Uy, si Sir Robles. Sir, good morning, sir. Jesus! Grabe. Damo man ko may nasugata nga faculty and staff kag pinakasapad sa tanan. Mga parents sa mga estudyante.
Ayok po.
Kag, siyempre, pinakadamo sa tanan, mga students. Sari-sari nga mga estudyante, ah. May mga pasaway. But, may mga mabuot man, ah. May naga...
Good morning, Chief.
Uy, good morning. Tapos, may naga... Uy, hello. Kung kisa, may galabay, gasmay lang, ah. Uy. See, good morning. Hay na lang. Pero sa makasami, mayara ginang opta! Din ka makadto, crop top, gagwa pusod, hindi na didri pwede. Beng? Hindi gyapon pwede. Labag sa dress code. Gasunod lang kami maybe sa babaw.
Iniyabin nong?
Sige, pwede na na. Kalanggit, nga do ka damo git sang bayo mo ha?
Mapractice abi kami sa field demo naman sa PE nung.
Ate, antes ka magsulod sa imo nga PE, tani nakailis ka na. Kabalo ka, magsulod ka dire ka maglibot sa CPO. May dress code kita nga ginasunod. Tapos, CW pasubong. So, manami gitani bala ko ng inyong pamayo, nagkakaangay man sa okasyon subong.
CEW? Ah! Amo na ang Christ Emphasis Week, no? Ang daw devotional. Ang ginatin nan sa mga students sa Rose Memorial. Ano pa, wala ko pinaka-attend, Chip. Pero, hambal sa mga upod ko, na may damag-attend, dira. Ginahagad man ko gani nila.
Devotional? Hindi ah. Line pa gina siya, miss. Kay kami kisadaan diri sa CPO, naga-devotional man kami mga guards. Kay part as ang program sa school na mag-devotional kami. Lain ni siya kag ang CEW. Sa CEW, damo na da mga students gakadto para makilala lina si Jesus bila nilang Diyos kag manluluwas.
Ah, amo na ang service or convocation ang ginatunan sa mga student during weekdays kada semester. Inang gakanta sila, praise and worship, prayer kag kapamati sermon daw.
Tama! Tsaka wagin, miss. Amo na gani nga dapat kamo bala mga students matenggit sang CW para kabalo ka mo kung paano batunon si Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior.
Sige, Chip. Malate ako abis sa practice namon.
Sige, sige. Tungod sa mga devotionals namon sa CPO, dito ko na kilala si Jesus Christ. Dito nag-umpisa ang relasyon ko sa iya. Amo ini ang pinakadako nga desisyon nga nagkambyo sang kabuhi ko kag ginapasalamatan ko gid ang CPO. Nami sa CPO ah, damo kong eksperyensya na dala halinto, di galing sa amon obra, way sang permanente. So, ipasaylo ko sa ibansang amon agency. Uy, my manager, good morning.
Good morning, Manong.
Miss, kung kay napabala kami digahulat, wala Japon cashier. Kung kay napaman kami nag-ring sang bell.
Ang maka-eskwela bilang isa ka work student. Kag sa CPU, daku ini nga oportunidad para sa pareho ko nga gusto mag-eskwela pero ginakapos pinansyal. Wala labot sa programa sang eskwelahan, may ara man sa mga faculty and staff nga naging mabinuligon gid sa amon nga mga work student pamaagi sa ila personal nga pamaagi. Labor is honor. Kag hindi basta-basta ang maagyan mo kung isa ka ka-work student. Pero damo gid ako natun-an sa pagiging work student. Kag inatanan nakabuligid sa akon hasta sa akon nga pag-ubra subong. Pero kisa, labor is horror man. Kapin pa kong sa rublihol ka ma-assign. Sininila, nagadula ko ng rublihol. According man niya sa iban, may nagakalas ko no. Hambal pagit sang iban, may nagapabatsyag ko no. Kagisa pa, may nagapakita ko no. Hindi ka magpate, mangkutaba lang ang mga working student kay damo ko nabatian na muning istorya. Hindi ko gito malimtan sang isa ka adlaw nga nag-overtime ko sa duty kay pagkapwas may laboratory. Gimpreparar ko na lang ang aparatos. Daw may nabatsyagan ko nga nagakalas. Kagpagbalikit ko
Dugay, dugay ka pada? Manirado na ako dugay-dugay, ha?
Ay, sige-sige nung. Wala man gali. Balaan nyo. Ilo na ako. Wala nanay. Wala man tatay. Sang wala ko mahibaluan kung din ko makadto. Nadiskubrihan ko git ang work student study program sang CPU. Dako git ang bulig sa akon. Kaagi ko sa clerical. Janitorial. Kag sa library. Oo, kululbaan gid man sa rublihol. Pero mas kululbaan kung hindi ko katapos eskwela, eh.
Miss? Mabalik na lang ko karon. May klase pa ko daan sa CPU kag base maliit na gid ko.
Ah, sige ma'am. Ma'am, sorry gid for the inconvenience.
It's okay. Ay, kado guys yung jeep, i-chat ko na lang anay ako ng mga students. Class. Please read pages 13 to 52 of your book and answer activity number 4. I will see you in a bit. Sent. Grabe! Hasta diri, gina-remind gid sa ako ng school bell. Oo na, ako nang daw malit. Wala chapon jeep na gapasakay. Okay, class. Copy and answer this one, and we will check this next meeting. Understood? Yes?
Ma'am, tapos ka na? Excuse, ma'am, pwede picturean ta ni inamon?
High-tech na gid ng mga students subong. Amo na kami ng mga teachers, dapat makasabay man sang ila pagka-tech savvy. Nadumduman ko man sang una kung paano man niya ang amon nga disiplina, kapin pa sa pagsulat-sulat.
Late ka man? Hambal ni ma'am ko no, masulat kita. I will not be late again. One whole, back to back. Hi.
Tod ka? Grabe mo na si ma'am yung man. Kapoy na ko talagaan, bro.
Kung matapos mo, ipas mo anay kay ma'am before ka mag-copy sa assignment ta sa board.
Ha? Tanan na ho? Kopyahon gid na? Amo ni ang disiplina sa una. Kapin pa sa pagsulat-sulat, mano-mano nga isulat sa papel ang kada letra.
Kung malate gani si ma'am, wala kami kabalo kung mapuli na kami o kung hindi, kay basi mag-abot pa siya. Pero, tungod sa akon sentralyan nga mga maestra, nga naging example gid sa akon sa pagtudlo kag sa pagdisiplina sa mga students para ma-impart ang EXCEL. Exemplary Christian Education for Life. Ako, na-inspire man nga manging isa ka maestra. Kagsubong, na-experyensyahan ko gid kung ano, kag paano ang transition sa CPU. Sang una, ng estudyante pa lang ako, kagsubong, nga nagamaestra naman, diri sa CPU. Okay, class, dismiss. Please don't forget your assignments next meeting, okay? May time pa man ko gali. Balikan ko na lang to ano yung sa mall, ah. Good afternoon. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. Bao pila magawa kag nakabalik ba? It's been a long, long time. But if only you know, my dear alma mater, that all through these years, wherever I went, whoever I was with, that your central spirit has been within me, deep within my heart. Kadamo naging tingin bag-o, mga buildings, classrooms, teknolohiya, mga guya, mga gwapo kag mga gwapa, dala na laway. But nothing can change the fact that you, my dear CPU, has always been and forever will be a very important and meaningful part of our individual lives. Kag samtang nagadugay CPU, ikaw nangin matutong sa pagpakita sang imumatahom na kinaiya. Bilang isa ka doktor, I can say that I have reached the pinnacle of my profession. Nakalabot na ako sa mga malayo ng mga pungsod, kama nakalain-lain ng mga syudad. But, whenever I get to visit you, my dear Central Philippine University, it always feels like home. Matuod gid ang mapululungon ni Dr. Rex Villon, and I quote, Central will be great again. It is, and it continues to be.
Thank you.
We would like to thank our performers and their advisors, the different groups who presented this afternoon, CPU Excel Choral, Teatro Sining at iba pa, and the CPU Dance Troupe. And a special acknowledgement for the men and women behind CENVA, Centralian Visual Artists Society, and their advisor, Mr. John Mark Kalumba, for the very special video presentation that they prepared for this afternoon's cultural show. Once again, a pleasant afternoon, alumni, friends, Centralians. We are now on the second part of our program, and that is the presentation of awards to our Centralian luminaries, the men and women who dedicated their professional life to Central Philippine University. But before that, a very special announcement. The business meeting and election of officers of the Federation of Overseas Alumni Association Incorporated have already started at the conference room 1 of the 4th floor Henry Luce III Library. We have prepared some snacks for our awardees, which you can partake later. So the refreshments are just on the left, right side of our stage. We will be dividing our awardees this afternoon, parts 1 and 2. But before we recognize our Centralian luminaries, let's give a round of applause to a very special song number that will be given to us by the BSN class of 1968 and their friends. A round of applause. After the recognition of Centralian luminaries will be the GMA Kapuso Show that will be here at Rose Memorial Auditorium, and our alumni, students, faculty, and staff are all invited to watch. Tomorrow at Grand Sing Imperial Hotel, we will be serenaded by Mr. Christian Bautista and, of course, Mr. Jose Marie Chan. So we would love to see you all there at Grand Sing Imperial Hotel. Once again, let us give a round of applause to our special performers to render a very special song number, BSN class of 1968 and friends.
In behalf of BSN 1968 and friends that composed some of our friends here, alumni, I would encourage you to sing with us. If you would like to stand up, the lyrics will be flashed on the board.
Thank you.
Thank you, BSN class of 1968. And friends, let's give them another round of applause. And another moment to be thankful for is the presence of our alumnus and the former chairman of the CPU Board of Trustees. Let us give a round of applause to Secretary Perfecto Jun Yasai Jr. Sir, may we request you to stand and say hello to the Centralian community. Welcome home, sir. And yes, we are graced not only by the presence of our proud alumni, but of men and women who served CPU and are part of the 114 years of CPU's history. And to this afternoon, we recognize these men and women. How did we select the Centralian luminaries? The following are the criteria for the selection. 75 years old and above. Must have rendered at least 20 years of service at CPU, except if he or she held an administrative position in the university and have served for at least 10 years. Must have severed his or her employment from CPU due to retirement. So now, ladies and gentlemen, we will be presenting the award to our Centralian luminaries, and they will receive a medallion and a cash award. The medallion is from the CPU administration, and the cash award is from the CPU Alumni Association Incorporated. The following individuals are requested to present the award to our luminaries, and a very special platform was constructed for them, and they will all be standing up and using that platform as they receive their award. So the individuals who will be presenting the award are also requested to be there. The following are the individuals who will present the award to our luminaries. CPU President, Dr. Teodoro C. Robles. CPU AAI President, Attorney Joshua Alim. Vice President for Student Affairs, Dr. Esther Rose Rumarate. Professor Rodel Palomar, Human Resource Office Director. And of course, Attorney Von Lovell Bidona, Chairman of the CPU Board of Trustees. Once again, our luminaries will receive a medallion and a cash award. Thank you to your service to Central Philippine University, Dr. Juanito Acanto. Dr. Juanito Acanto is represented by his son, Mr. Juanito Acanto Jr. Dr. Juanito Acanto is the third Filipino president of Central Philippine University. Second awardee, Ms. Melida Agriam, staff, Junior High School. Miss Angelica Altis, Faculty Member, College of Education. Mr. Salvador Alvarez, Faculty Member of the College of Arts and Sciences, to receive the award on Mr. Alvarez's behalf will be his grandchildren, Kent Alfe Alvarez and Princess Aleia Alvarez, together with Mrs. Maria Fe Alvarez. Our next Centralian luminary is Miss Marcelina Arellano, faculty member of the junior high school. Let's give a round of applause to our awardees. Miss Teresita Arevalo, faculty member of the junior high school. Our next luminary is Ms. Patrocinia Ariete, staff from the Student Service Enterprise. Our next awardee, Professor Gloria Ariola, Personnel Officer. Let us give a round of applause to our next Centralian luminary, Reverend Prudencio Banyas, faculty member, College of Theology. Our next awardee is Ms. Evelina Buenafe, faculty member, junior high school. Our next awardee is Mr. Eugelo Cachupero, staff from the dining hall. He will be, on behalf of Mr. Eugelo Cachupero, he is represented by his daughter, Miss Yuli Cachupero. Our next awardee is Mr. Antonio Caipang, Supervisor, Facilities Maintenance Services, and he is accompanied by Mr. Evany Caipang, his son. Our next luminary is Dr. Lucy Catalogo, Principal, Elementary School. Our next Centralian luminary is the former dean of the College of Medicine, Dr. Glenn A.M. Catedral. Our next awardee is Ms. Luz Catolico, staff from the College of Commerce, who cannot be with us this afternoon. Another Centralian luminary is Professor Lucy De La Fuente, faculty member of the English Department. And to claim the award on her behalf is Reverend Manuel De La Fuente. Our next luminary is Mr. Merlin De Doroy, Staff, Buildings and Grounds. And Mr. De Doroy will be accompanied by Ms. Zina Ruth Dianala. Thank you. The one receiving the award is Miss Zina Ruth Dianala, receiving the award on behalf of Miss Ruth Dianala, faculty member of the junior high school. At this point, we will be presenting the award to Mr. Merlin De Doroy, staff, buildings, and grounds. Thank you, Mr. Merlin De Doroy. Our next awardee is Mr. Vicente Doromal, faculty member of Junior High School. To our friends who are watching via Facebook Live, this is the awarding of the Centralian Luminaries. Our next awardee is Ms. Caridad Escoban, Staff Student Service Enterprise. Our awardee will be accompanied by Mr. Andrew Escoban. Our next awardee is Ms. Rebecca Espina, staff from the College of Commerce, and Ms. Adelta Ispolong, librarian, elementary school. However, these two awardees cannot be with us this afternoon. Our next Centralian luminary is Mr. Jonah Eusebio, staff, buildings and grounds. Our next Centralian luminary is Reverend Dr. Nathaniel Fabula, Vice President for Academic Affairs. Thank you. thank you once again and congratulations to our Centralian Luminaries. We will have first a very brief pause. And let us first allow our presenters of the award to also rest a little and our some of our luminaries to enjoy their snacks first before we proceed to the second part. So at this point, we will have a very quick break. And while we are enjoying our quick break, we will also enjoy to listening to a very special song number from the BSN class of 1968 and friends. We welcome them back to the stage. A round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. To all our alumni who are here right now and maybe watching our Facebook Live, we would like to invite you to check out the trade fair at the Promenade. And also, if you are still interested to get a copy of your songbook and souvenir book, they are also available. Once again, you may want to check out the trade fair at the Promenade, and songbook and souvenir books are still available. Ladies and gentlemen, another round of applause to the BSN class of 1968 and friends.
May we request those who could stand to stand so you can stretch a little bit. The ones on top, join us in singing, okay? Students can join us. This is more of our benediction to you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. And let's give another round of applause, a resounding applause, to BSN Class of 1968 and friends. We continue with the second part of our presentation of awards to our Centralian luminaries. May I once again request Dr. Robles, Attorney Joshua Alim, Dr. Esther Rose Romarate, Professor Rodel Palomar, and Attorney Von Bedona. All our students, alumni, faculty, and staff are invited to the GMA Kapuso Show here at Rose Memorial Auditorium. We continue with our second part of the presentation of awards. Our next Centralian luminary is Professor Lemuel Gardose, Chairperson of the PE Department, and Ms. Blanquita Henshaneo, Faculty Member of the Junior High School. Unfortunately, Professor Gardose and Ms. Henshaneo cannot be with us this afternoon, as well as our next awardee, Ms. Cecilia Goles, Credit and Collection Manager. Our next Centralian luminary is Professor Elizabeth Gorospe, faculty member of the English Department. Our next awardee is Dr. Eliza Grino, Chairperson of the English Department. To receive the award on Ma'am Grino's behalf is her son, Mr. Francis Grino. Later, Dr. Grino will be giving us a video response. Next awardee is Ms. Lydia Grillo, Staff, College of Engineering. Our next Centralian luminary is Professor Violeta Gilirgan, faculty member of the College of Arts and Sciences. Our next awardee is Ms. Mildred Harder, faculty member, Junior High School. Our next Centralian luminary is Dr. Elma Herradura, Vice President for Academic Affairs. To receive the award on Dr. Herradura's behalf is Dr. Faith Daphne Herradura Estrada. Our next awardee is Ms. Edith Italia, Staff, College of Nursing. Our next awardee is Ms. Natividad Hagonase, Coordinator, University Student Center. Ms. Nilda Halbuna, Faculty Member, College of Arts and Sciences. Ms. Elsa Hinon, Librarian, Junior High School. Ms. Perlita Kilaiko, Faculty Member, Junior High School. Unfortunately, our awardees cannot be with us this afternoon. Our next Centralian luminary is Engineer Aurora Lim, Special Assistant to the President on Environmental Concerns. Our next awardee is Professor Hermenegilda Masa, faculty member, Social Sciences Department. Our awardee will be accompanied by Mr. Edward Massa. Our next Centralian luminary is Dr. Angelica Padernilia, Principal Elementary School. Our next awardees, Ms. Linda Pagunstan, Staff, Registrar's Office, and Mr. Ernesto Pantoja, another staff, could not make it this afternoon. Our next luminary is Mr. Oscar Pingoy, Staff, Johnson Hall. On behalf of Mr. Pingoy is his daughter, Ms. Carmen Genoveza, to receive the award. Our next Centralian luminary is Dr. Agustin Polido, the second Filipino president of Central Philippine University. Our next Centralian luminary is Professor Corazon Rabulan, faculty member, College of Education. Professor Rabulan is accompanied by her daughter, Miss Joanna Christine Rabulan, SVP of Security Bank. Our next awardee is Dr. Walden Rio, Vice President for Administration. Our next awardee is Professor Purificacion Robles, Chairperson, Chemistry Department. Our next awardees, Ms. Elisia Sampiano, Ms. and Ms. Lita Cepeda. Ms. Sampiano is a staff from the business office and Ms. Cepeda is a faculty member of the junior high school. Couldn't make it this afternoon. Our next Centralian luminary is Ms. Elma Solas, faculty member, elementary school. Our next awardee is Miss Florentina Somoshera, Staff Guidance Services Center. To receive the award on Ma'am Somoshera's behalf are to receive the award on Ms. Somoshera's behalf are Engineer Stanley Somoshera and Engineer Carlos Somoshera Jr. Our next awardee is Mr. Demi Sonza, Director, Office of Planning and Development. Our next Centralian luminary is Professor Aileen Travinia, faculty member, College of Arts and Sciences. Our last awardee who couldn't be with us this afternoon is Mr. Eugenio Vaflor, faculty member of the College of Arts and Sciences. We have a total of 55 Centralian luminaries. We would like to thank the chairperson of our Board of Trustees, Attorney Von Bedona, Dr. Teodoro Robles, our CPU President, Attorney Joshua Alim, the President of CPU AAI, Vice President Dr. Esther Rose Romarate, and Professor Rodel Palomar. Once again, that concludes the presentation of awards to our Centralian luminaries. A round of applause to these men and women. We would like to request to respond on behalf of the luminaries, Mr. Demi Sonza.
Trustee Chairman Von Bedona, other trustees, University President Ted Robles, Alumni President Joshua Alem, fellow alumni, students, good afternoon. I am honored to give the response on behalf of the CPU luminaries. As you can see, or as you have seen, we are all in the late afternoon or in the twilight time of life. But since we were honored as luminaries, which means still shining, you can call each one of us the bright evening star. And speaking of the evening star, I am reminded of my late father, who was poor and uneducated, but he had a dream for his children. One morning, when I was in grade one, my father called me to the window of our Nipa hut and said to me, "Toto, look at the bright kabugwason." I said, "Tatay, that is the morning star." He said, "You are right. Now you study very well so that you will become a bright morning star." Then again, when I was in grade six, father was standing on the ground beside our house and called to me and said, "Toto, come here. Do you see the bright kasisidmon?" I said, "Tatay, that is Hesperos. I learned that in our science class. that is Hesperos, the evening star. But you know, Tatay, I said, the evening star and the morning star are not stars. They are not real stars. They are the planet Venus that orbits around the Earth like the moon. And so, there are times when it appears to us as a morning star, and at other times, it comes up as the evening star. Wonderful, Tatay said to me, wonderful. Now you are a bright morning star. Study hard, strive hard, so that when you get old, you will become a bright evening star. Then he said to me, Toto, it's about time I tell you, I have a dream for you. My dream for you is to go to college. Bisan imol kami ni nanay mo, mga budlay kami todo-todo para makatapos ka high school. And kung matapos mo high school, siguro makapanga. Ikaw na bagsay kang imote mo baroto, maka-eskwila ka sa kolehiyo. You understand what that means? So I followed his advice. I graduated from high school, an honor student, only to find out that I could not go on to college. My father could not afford the cost. So for 1 year, I was an out-of-school youth. But then, God was good and is still good. To make the story short, the following year, I was accepted at CPO as a working student. And when I was here, within a month, I found out that Tatay's dreaming for his children was biblical. I saw that in the book of the prophet Joel, chapter 2, verse 28, the Lord says, I will pour my spirit upon the people. Their sons and daughters will prophesy. Their old men will dream dreams, and their young men will see visions. Because my father had dreams for us, 10 children, all of us saw visions of a bright future for us. Here at CPU, I honed my talent in writing. My first book, a volume of poetry, was published in 1955 by the university. The very first book printed by the newly acquired CPU Printing Press. That was followed by 3 other books in the following years. I was still here. So I became quite a celebrity. But the most important thing that happened to me at CPU was my knowing Jesus and accepting Him as my Lord and Savior. I imbibe here the work ethic, the Christian values that served me well later on when I worked in government and elsewhere. And by the grace of God, my father lived long enough to see his dream come true. Before he died in 1996 at age 87, father's eldest son was vice governor of Iloilo, and the 10th and youngest child was supervisor of the CPU Media Center, Ed Sonsa. I am sure the other awardees have their own stories to tell, stories akin to mine. Stories of transformation, of development, of growth in life. Stories that led them to the life abundant, as promised by the Lord when He said, I have come that they may have life and have it fully. My friends, now I am out of government. My last term as board member expired June 30 last. So I'm out of government, but I tell you, I'm not yet out of public service. I'm still on the board of Taytay sa Kauswagan, the Christian Microfinance Institution, which has 250 offices from Luzon to Mindanao, employs about 3,000 people, so many of them Centralians. And I am still chairman of several subsidiary corporations of TSKI, like Boracay Property Holdings, the Iloilo Gateway Hotel, and the last to be established is the TSKI Skills and Knowledge Institute. And I'm still writing. Tomorrow, I'll conduct a seminar at the Casa Real de Iloilo. I'm still active. And so are all of these people here. In their own right, they are still shining. We are luminaries. We are the evening stars. Praise the Lord. And thank you, CPU, for remembering us. To him, from all good gifts come, be honor and glory now and throughout eternity. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Dr. Demi Sonza. We will once again listen to another response, this time through a video from Dr. Grinio. May we play the video?
I'm glad to be with you today, even though I am here at home. As you can see, I really meant to be there with you, but some restraining things, like an immune system that refuses to work well in very old people, are keeping me from enjoying your company. Another has to do with wild animals. Remember the relation to the outbreak of the new coronavirus in Wuhan, China? Well, my son Judson calls me his dinosaur because I am now into my 99th year. A dinosaur is to be considered a wild animal. Judson wants to be sure that I, his dinosaur, don't contaminate you. But he cannot prevent me from expressing the gratitude of your honorees today. Fellow Centralians, you who are our true evidence of the rightness and worthwhileness of the efforts we old workers spent in helping the learners nurtured by our beloved school, we whom you are honoring, thank you for this offering of affection. In return, we honor you too for showing the world what good true Centralians can bring to places where they establish themselves. You make us very proud. I am sure that those who founded this school and those who labored with and after them are happy to see that the dreams for Filipino youth in the establishment of this school are realizable. What better evidence of this confidence can be shown than your grand reunion here today? Let us give thanks and glory to the Lord. But we are not yet done. How do we see ourselves in the future? Allow me to suggest that we give hope to coming generations by being their gleaming light at the dawn of a new century. Long live Central. Again, thank you very much for remembering us who are about to fade away.
There we have it, responding on behalf of the Luminaries, Mr. Demi Sonza and Dr. Eliza Grino. Another round of applause. Once again, we will focus our attention to the screen that we have here on stage, as there will be a video presentation of the activities that happened today. Let us all enjoy.
I warmly welcome all of you to this back-to-back event.
I hope you enjoy the same day edit video that was prepared for all of us this afternoon. May I request everyone to please rise for the closing prayer to be led by Pastor Mary Grace Labis.
Brothers and sisters in the Lord, let us unite in prayer. God of love end of life, we thank you for the many gifts and for all the blessings you have given us. We know that all of our blessings comes from you alone. This is the reason that we always give ourselves to be used by you. We thank you for the presence of our awardees and their families, and even for those who were not around. We praise you for the gift of unity that the Spirit creates in our relationship and fellowship here in Central Philippine University. You place others perfectly in our lives and inspire us as Christians to work together with the gifts that we have been blessed with. When we look at this gathering through your eyes, we see your gifts fostered in us to further your plans. So as we depart and others will stay, we ask you to bless each of us as we have our life continue to live out your grace in and outside of these walls. We pray that you bless our hearts and minds as we are operating within your will. Help us to take the love that we feel for each other and guide our steps to be faithful friends and extensions of your love to others or for those who are in need. Bless us, Lord, to take your passion with us. Now, through the power of the Holy Spirit that dwells in us through our belief in Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, my brothers and sisters in the Lord, walk faithfully after Christ, reflecting his love in your life. Amen. God bless everyone.
Once again, to our Centralian Luminaries, thank you for the many years of service that you have given to Central Philippine University. To everyone, may we all enjoy the rest of the day.